Good morning friends, I am Neeraj Bhadresa and our today's topic that is IMP of unit number 1 that is complex number. So we start our session. So first point that is complex number that is always start with I. So we write down some importance theory here. I is equal to I. For example, I is equal to I. That means we can say that I is equal to under root of minus 1. Now inside the complex number we use different types of I formula. For example, I square. So I square that is nothing but minus 1. So whenever any equation that gives I square, so we write replace of I square by minus 1. Now same as I cube. If I cube is there, so we can simplify the I cube value. So I cube is equal to I square into I. So if we replace I square value that is minus 1. So I square that is minus 1 into I. So we write I cube is equal to minus I. Same as if any equation that we see I raised to 4. So if I raised to 4, we want to simplify it. So I raised to 4 is equal to I square into I square. So if I square is equal to minus 1, we substitute the value of minus 1 to this equation. So finally minus 1 into minus 1 is equal to minus 1 into minus 1, that is equal to 1. So I raised to 4 is equal to 1. So basic formula I square is equal to minus 1, I cube is equal to minus I, and finally I raised to 4 is equal to 1. But now in our problem, suppose if we see I raised to 5, I raised to 6, I raised to 7, then we can simplify I raised to 4. Suppose if you want to simplify I raised to 5, then I raised to 5 that is nothing but again I square into I square into I. 2 to 4, 4 plus 1. So that is I raised to 5. We substitute the value of I square is equal to minus 1 here. So I square is equal to minus 1. Again I square is equal to minus 1 into I. Minus 1 into minus 1, that is nothing but 1. So 1 into I. So finally we can write I raised to 5 is equal to I. Same ways, if I raised to 6, you want to simplify I raised to 6. So I raised to 6, that is simplify I square into I square into I square. So in terms of square, we want to simplify I raised to 6. So if we substitute the value of I square is equal to minus 1. So here I square is equal to minus 1. Again here I square is equal to minus 1. And again here I square is equal to minus 1. So minus 1 into minus 1, that becomes 1 into minus 1 is equal to minus 1. So we can write down I raised to 6 is equal to minus 1. So in same way we can analysis our data I raised to 7, I raised to 8 and I raised to 9. Now we want to move to our next theory. Next theory that is Z value that is defined as a complex number. Z is equal to x plus iy. So if we write x plus iy, if z is equal to x plus iy, now we want to simplify z is equal to x plus iy. Now in any type of problem, if you want to find out mod z, then mod z is equal to under root of x square plus y square. So in any data, suppose we want to find mod z, then mod z is equal to under root of x square plus y square. Now again in any type of problem we want to find out or simplify, we can say that two value, that is if z1 is equal to x1 plus iy1, in any type of problem we want to find out z1 plus z2. Suppose z1 is equal to x1 plus iy1, z2 is equal to x2 plus iy2, and if you want to find out z1 plus z2, what is z1 plus z2? That is nothing but addition of the two complex number. Here z1 is equal to x1 plus iy1 and z2 is equal to x2 plus iy2. So addition of the two complex number, that is nothing but addition of the without I value, that is x1 plus x2, and addition of the with I value, that is nothing but plus iy1 plus iy2. So we can simplify x1 plus x2 and simplify here I, so I y1 plus y2. So in this way we can find out two complex number addition. Now we want to move to next theory. Suppose we want to subtract two value, that is z1 minus z2. So using z1 minus z2, we can write our equation in this way: z1 minus z2 is equal to here x1 plus iy1. Substitute z1 is equal to x1 plus iy1. So x1 plus iy1 minus sign, that is as it is. Now replace the z2 value by x2 plus iy2. So minus x2 plus iy2. Using addition without I value and then with I value. So same way, subtraction without I value and then with I value subtraction. So if we simplify our above equation, that is nothing but x1 without I here in this equation, that is nothing but only x2. So x1, but sign that is minus. So x1 minus x2, and now with I value, if we common out iy1 and iy2 in this equation, we can take common value of I. So then if plus I, and finally y1 and y2, but sign that is negative. So y1 minus y2. So in this way we can find out total three terms. First of all, what is the mod z? Mod z, that is nothing but under root of without I value square plus with I value square. Now if any problem we want to find out addition of the complex number, so x1 plus x2 plus I, y1 plus y2. And any problem, suppose if you want to find out subtraction of the two complex number, so x1 minus x2 plus I, y1 minus y2. Now we want to move to our next set of theory. Suppose we want to multiply two complex number, any sum, we want to find out what is the multiplication of the two complex number. So first of all, we want to assume z1 is equal to x1 plus iy1 and z2 is equal to x2 plus iy2. Now we want to analysis what is the multiply value of the z1 multiply by z2. Now we want to assume first z1 is equal to x1 plus iy1, and we want to assume z2 is equal to x2 plus iy2. Now multiply of the two z1 into z2, multiply z1 into z2 is equal to replace the z1 value by x1 plus iy1. So here x1 plus iy1, multiply sign here as it is, that means dot. Now z2 value, we are assume value, that is x2 plus iy2. So multiply with x2 plus iy2. Now we want to simplify our two equation or two bracket, that is x1 multiply with second bracket first term, then x1 that is again multiply with iy2. In second case, iy1 that is multiply with x2, and iy1 that is multiply with iy2. Now we want to simplify in this way. So here x1 that is multiply with x2, so that becomes x1 into x2. Now first equation, x1 again multiply with I y2, so that becomes plus I x1 into y2, x1 into y2. Now iy1, that is multiply with x2, so that becomes plus I y1 into x2. We can write first term x, that is x2, and write second term as a y, so I x2 into y1. Now last term, that is I y1 multiply with I y2, so finally that becomes plus I square I into I, that becomes I square y1 into y2, y1 into y2. Our analysis, our first theory says that I square is equal to minus 1. So if you want to replace here I square is equal to minus 1, so replace this equation I square is equal to minus 1 and take common from I x1 y2 plus I x2 y1, we can take a common of I. Now above equation we can simplify x1 into x2, here term I x1 y2 and I x2 y1, take a common value of I, so becomes I, and x1 into y2 plus x2 y1. Now replace I square is equal to minus 1, so minus 1 into plus, that becomes minus 1, so our sign that becomes here negative, and y1 into y2. So we can say that if you want to multiply two complex number, then our answer that becomes x1 into x2 minus y1 into y2 plus I x1 into y2 plus x2 into y1. And our simplification rule, that is nothing but simplify our two equation using a plus b into a plus again b, same equation. Now we want to move to our next set of theory. Suppose if you want to find out division of the two complex number, our first set of theory, that is nothing but we can find out addition of the two complex number, and then we want to find out subtraction of the two complex number, then we find out multiplication of the two complex number, and our next theory, that is nothing but find out division of the two complex number. So if you want to find out z1 divided by z2, so first of all we want to must assume z1 value and z2 value. Here we assume z1 is equal to x1 plus iy1, z2 is equal to x2 plus iy2. Now we want to find out z1 divided by z2. Suppose if you want to find out division of the two complex number, then basic set of theory, that is nothing but replace z1 by its value, so our value, that is x1 plus iy1, so here x1 plus iy1 division, that is sign as it is, divide by, replace z2 value by its our equation here x2 plus iy2, so here x2 plus iy2. Y2. This is nothing but substitutes is original value z1 and z2. Now we want to find out this value in terms of a plus ib form. So we want to convert our this equation x1 plus iy1 divided by x2 plus iy2 into a, that is nothing but without I, plus ib, that is nothing but with I value. So we can simplify our equation by take a rationalization of the denominator term. Denominator term contain x2 plus iy2, so multiply and divide by x2 minus iy2 and multiply x2 minus iy2. Both the value that are same, So ultimately we can got our original equation here. This is step that is nothing but is called rationalization step. Now numerator term we want to multiply and denominator term we want to multiply. So we can simplify our above equation like this way: x1 plus iy1 multiply x2 minus iy2 divide by x2 plus iy2 multiply x2 minus iy2. So again we want to take a multiplication of our numerator term and we want to take a multiplication term of our division term. So multiplication like this way: x1 into x2, x1 into iy2, iy1 into x2 and iy1 and iy2 multiply. Replace this sign, that is as it is. So our numerator term becomes x1 into x2, that is x1 into x2, x1 multiply with I by 2 and sign that is negative. So minus I x1 into y2. Now second step, that is I y1 multiply with x2 value. So multiplication, that is sign here plus, so put here plus I y1. So I y1 multiply with x2. Now plus n minus, so sign that is minus I y1 multiply with I y2. So ii that becomes I square y1 into y2. Now we want to take simplify of our denominator term, but look at the simplify way we want to multiply our denominator term.